Well, welcome everybody to Mount Van Hovenberg for the penultimate day of cross-country skiing here at the Nordic venue. And we're here for the women's 3.5K relay competition. There are 14 teams in the competition. So they all start off together in this relay contest. The first two laps will be skied by the first skiers. It's the 2.5 kilometer track that they are on, and they will do that twice and then hand over to the second skier, who will then do two laps of skate, and then final skier again doing skating. So Finns will go with the start number three. They all go off together, but they go in waves, so rows of three on the start grid. Watch out for France. They've got Amelia Suifet as their anchor skier in the final leg. Yeah, weather conditions, it's snowing, obviously, and it's only just snowing, -1 degrees centigrade, so just under the freezing line. So we are ready to go. So wearing bib number one, it's Kobayashi of Japan. Two is Meyer of Germany. Olkinen will go first for Finland. She won a silver medal in the sprint, and they're off and we're going, we're underway. Kazakhstan with Rakishova. France have Tanya Kurek, Astrid Stav of Norway, United States of America with Sofia Mazzoni, and Ukraine with Anastasia Nikon wearing bib 10. And we did think the Finns would go out and go out hard, and they're doing just that. Tia Olkinen already setting the early pace. So Aisha Rakishova of Kazakhstan wearing bib 6 there, looking good. And the French skier, Tanya Kurek. So Tanya Kurek leads Tia Olkinen of Finland. It's really important to stay in a group so that you get the benefit of that slipstream. You don't want that gap to open up. Someone's going to close that down. You can see the German there, Selina Meyer, wearing bib number two, double poling furiously. So if a gap develops, it's very difficult to close it up. Need to stay together, particularly with this soft snow. The leading skier does have the disadvantage of plowing through the new snow, and also if you're following, you get the advantage of the aerodynamic slipstreaming effect. Kobayashi looking like she's slipping backwards, number one there. Wearing bib 6 from Kazakhstan, it is Aisha Rakishova. So Rakishova goes through the first split in the lead, but it's all together in this pack. So there is a distinct group of seven. And then the Swiss Vola, the Italian Sordello. So we're down to this gruppetto at the front of seven skiers past the lodge, and they will be reaching the halfway point of their effort.
Well, one of the things that they've been incredibly good at is the chess game of Nordic ski, and the Japanese are very, very good.
One of the things that the racers have to watch out for is the deadly ice user. You never want to see that huge pole step up by the eye.
As we see the Finn leading the
And now we have a group of four.
That is Tia Olkinen out in front.
And Tia Olkinen is setting a blistering pace here.
First lap. We have five more laps to go. One more lap in the Classic before the next exchange.
Another one of the skiers who would love to get on that train is the French skier wearing bib number 7. That is Tania Curet, joining us from France, wearing bib number 7, number 6.
Well,
also in the mix right
bib
there.
7 there, going up the climb. Herring burning up on top of the Classic, the cut track there. Chopping up the track. Now look at the Japanese go. Kobayashi. And the German. Anna Maria, Selina Meyer. Anna Maria Dietzer will be the anchor for Germany. It's Selina Meyer who's taking things out now. Tia Olkinen won a silver medal in the sprint event, and this could be just a little bit too much, too long for the Finn. She's dropping away from the lead now. It's the Japanese that have decided to put the hammer down, and look at Olkinen. Olkinen is gasping. So Kobayashi's making a move there on the climb. Now on to the descent. Who's going to be bravest around this corner? So Kobayashi leads, the German Meyer behind her, trying to make a move on the outside. Look at how Meyer just skis straight past Kobayashi on the descent. And she's bringing through Olkinen of Finland in the slipstream. And that's a great example of how you have difference in speeds on the uphill and the descent. And that is why Kobayashi went to the front. She knew that she could potentially get dropped on the descent, and the best way of not getting dropped is to be leading. So four, five teams still in touch. And just getting the line slightly wrong there, heading towards the finish rather than the transition. And the tag.
Teammate from Finland, that is Olkinen tagging off to Karanen.
Karanen will take it on for Finland, and the Japanese will hand over to Honda. The Germans, Meyer hands over to Stocker. And the French, Kurech, hands over to Felice Chappas. So now we're going on to skate, so the speed will be slightly quicker. Now at the transition, there was only a lead of 2 seconds over Kobayashi. And that has definitely extended. So Karanen is leading this out and is skiing very quickly. The Finns could well win all three of these legs. So Karanen crossing the 7.1 kilometer mark, almost halfway through her effort. 11 seconds, Chappas is closing the gap and bringing Honda with her. They've gained 2 seconds there on the descent. Anderson is the one that's moving forward, 23 seconds back now. That's a big improvement from Anderson.
The whole kind of a balance about being a little bit slower in the uphill.
So the Finns doing very well here. As across the first lap, she will wait until probably halfway through the second lap before she really starts to go for it. 12 seconds. Now, the chasers are catching. But Andersen from Norway is the one. Selma Andersen wearing bib 8. She's the one that's skiing through the field and putting Norway back in touch for a medal. And Karianne Olsvik Dengerud will be the anchor for Norway. Yeah, I'm just looking at... Whoa! Yeah, a fall there for the French, for Felice Chapaz. Just got the weight ever so slightly backwards as she went around that corner. And that was the moment that Honda then regained the lead over Chapaz. And that was a shame because Chapaz was skiing quickly and was starting to close the gap on the leader. So just risking a little bit too much. And that fall has really knocked the wind out of her. Uninjured, but just slipping back two places. And look at Andersen coming through. Andersen is going to move up into second place. And look at the Finn. She's starting to really struggle. She's gone out too hard. She went out too fast, too hard on the very first leg, on the very first lap of this second leg. And she is going to get caught. But she is going to hand over to the double gold medalist, Hila Niemelä. So maybe that was a tactic. Go out hard, go out as fast as you can. Try and hold off the opposition. But now Japan and Norway. And I fully expect Norway with Andersen to go straight past here. Andersen has the inside line on this corner. Honda from Japan just dropping in behind the Finn, but it's Andersen of Norway who's just saying, right, I've caught you, now I'm going to pass you. Norway will hand over to Karianne Dengerud. Cheers for Selma. Selma Andersen. No problems around this high-speed corner. And look at the speed that the Finn could carry out of the descent there. The Finns really have got the wax right. Now it's the Japanese that's going to go on the hill. So Chika Honda, the Japanese are quick up these steep, sharp hills. And Chika Honda decided to, this is the time that she's going to make her move. But Andersen is staying with her. And she will hand over to Sobue Rin, who won a gold in the team. Well, like I think Andersen might be slightly cooked. Japan are going to hand over first. And the speed there of Sobue Rin takes out for Japan. So Dengerud from Norway, and here we go with the double gold medalist, Hila Niemelä of Finland. France also in touch. They've handed over to Emile Suife. So any one of these top four could potentially still win gold. Sabue is 6 seconds ahead of Dengerud. Now, what's that star for Niemelä for? There's a star in front, behind Niemelä's name.
but the other three behind them, Ruud, Jemela, and Stupé, have gained a fair amount of time because at the exchange.
So potentially Niemela could be in on for a penalty there, a star appearing next to her name on the scoreboard. Could that have been something that we didn't see in transition? Was there no tag?
Feel that thundering herd right behind her.
Well, there is a little bit of when you know you're going to catch someone, you can leave them out in front for a little bit longer than they want. You want to time the catch so that you can go catch them and then hopefully go straight past them. You don't want to spend too much energy so that when you come level, you're right on the limit. You want to ideally come level so that you've got something in reserve to then go straight past.
The final 2.5K to determine who will be on top of the podium. Rinsover in the driver's seat by the lead continues to shrink down to 1.5 seconds for Niemela. Once again, with an asterisk by the side of her name, we're going to have to wait to see what the jury will have to determine why that.
So Niemela is in second place, but there is an asterisk, a star next to her name. So there's a penalty for something. We're not quite sure what it is. Dengerud of Norway in third place, and they've all come together in a group of four. So that's it. They've closed the gap. This is the final lap, the final 2.5 kilometers. So Subue Rin still leading this four. And look, the four have been caught. It's been a great ski from the Kazakhstani Shalagina. Shalagina and Anna Maria Dietza are closing right up. I do get the feeling that when they do catch, they'll be so exhausted, though. Well, certainly the German looks to be done. So Niemela still looking very strong, very powerful. Shalagina there wearing bib six for Kazakhstan. You can see how hard she's had to work to close the gap. Potentially could get on the medal if there's a penalty for Finland. Then it might open things up. Finland would drop out of this. Got Finland leading Norway. Shalagina of Kazakhstan overtaking the French. Might have been better off just letting herself get caught by the group earlier on and sitting in. As look at Shalagina go. Shalagina has done a great job to ski herself right back into contention and has come from nowhere. And Niemela looks as though, where on earth did you come from? So at the transition, at the exchange, Kazakhstan were 27 seconds back. And Shalagina has skied brilliantly to close that gap. So we have three out in front. Norway and Finland, their ski speed so fast. Shalagina, who's had to work so far, so hard to get where she is. It's Finland that are going to make the move. This is the final climb. This is where the medals are going to be decided. Niemela, she's leading up the final climb. She has the lead over Dengerud. Dengerud's trying to hang on. Shalagina works so hard to catch them, just doesn't quite have the reserves. Shalagina, though, could hang on for a medal. Subue of Japan in fourth, Suife of France in fifth, as Niemela will come down towards the line. But we need to wait and see what the star is for and what that penalty will be. Niemelä, oh, just on the back seat there. This is going to be a tight one. It's Dengerud versus Niemelä. I think Niemelä will have the speed, and yes, she does. Niemelä skiing well out in front. Oh, here comes Dengerud. Here comes Dengerud. Kariana Dengerud is not going to do it. It's going to be Finland that crossed the line first. Norway in second. Kazakhstan will cross in third. And Sobue Rin of Japan will cross in fourth place. So now we will wait and see what the star next to the Finnish team's name means, but hopefully it won't mean a disqualification. And Finland take gold, Norway will take silver, Kazakhstan will take bronze. And the Finns have done it again. So confirmation of the result. The asterisk that we saw was just a warning. It was a yellow card. And Finland are confirmed as the gold medalists. Finland in gold, Norway in silver, and Kazakhstan in bronze.
First place and cross-country skiing women's 3x5 kilometer relay classic free champion, Finland.
And Finland,
Tia Olkinen,
the gold medalist,
Kaurinen, and Hilla Niemelä.
So from left to right, it's Olkinen, Kaurinen, and Niemelä.
The Lake Placid 2023 FISU World University Games winners.
Confirmation that Finland take yet another gold medal, Norway in silver, and Kazakhstan in bronze.
Japanese team now tagging
in the second lap. I will say this:
of the last lap, Finland's going back.